Are Nigerians scammers? When someone introduces himself to you as a Nigerian, what is your impression about him or her? Do you immediately doff your cap of suspicion, readjust your seat, and engage all your security consciousness? But what if the Nigerian you are dealing with is an innocent fellow, probably more honest than an average European or American? Did I hear you say impossible? Well, you have reasons to take that stance. You have heard and read a lot of Nigerians' escapades with people's resources. Many have been swindled by Nigerians, enough sensitize you against losing your guard when you are dealing with one. Nigeria is also in the news for the wrong reasons. If it's not about insecurity, it'll be about bad governance, outright embezzlement or mismanagement of public funds, and corruption to mention a few. The worst of it is all sorts of fraud that the African sleeping giant is connected with. But wait a minute. Could these noising and bombalation not be fanning furore for some haters who are threatened by the potentials of Nigerians who find themselves in better organized societies? It is better to view this matter with the lens of fairness. To answer the question titling this discussion in a balanced manner devoid of any prejudice, 4 more questions are in order. 1. Are there scammers in and among Nigerians? 2. Are all Nigerians scammers? 3. Are there scammers from other countries who are worse than Nigerians? And 4. Are there good Nigerians who are excelling in their chosen legit profession worldwide, probably advancing the course of countries that where they live? Let us analyze these questions and find a balanced spot to hold. Are there scams in Nigeria? Even the dunce and the most gullible person knows that scam thrives and flourishes in Nigeria. The land is a fertile ground for the menace. It is all too easy to be scammed, as there is low access to public information. The database is virtually non-existent. The unemployment rate is skyrocketing, becoming one of the highest in the world. There is multifaceted corruption in high places and sharp practices in the commercial and educational sectors. Fraudulent practices are just the norm in such a climb. It is not understandable, then, that the tendency to be involved in fraud is rife in the land. All forms of fraud ever known to the world have perpetrated in the country. The most notorious one that gives Nigeria a bad reputation is the advance fee scam, also known as 419. It is a type of confidence trick involving promising the victim a large share of money in return for an upfront payment to facilitate the access to the bigger sum. The words 419 and 419ers are common in Nigerian society and used as when referring to scamming, scammers, con men, and duping or being duped. This scam has come to be known as the Nigerian scam or Nigerian prince scam, not because it originates in Nigeria, but because it is commonly used by Nigerians worldwide. Other scams making waves in Nigeria are employment scams, lottery scams, pet scams, online and sales rental scams, romance scams, and mobile tower installation frauds, just to mention a few. Nigerian news have given other designation to the internet fraud and fraudsters, namely Yahoo, Yahoo Boys and Girls. Yes, that is the fact in Nigerian society anywhere Nigerians live, whether home or abroad. However, is the appalling picture painted above enough basis for stereotyping? That will be for a straight-jacketed and narrow-minded individual. An objective thinker will like to see Nigerians 100% to have a well-rounded understanding of the Nigerian spirit. And that brings us to the next question. Is every Nigerian a scammer? The fact speaks for themselves. If all Nigerians are scammers, why do foreign nationals ply their trades in Nigeria? Statistics show that foreign multinational corporation competes favorably with Nigerian firms in Nigeria. Despite the local content acts and other government incentives to promote local businesses, multinationals rake billions of dollars from Nigeria to their countries every financial year. Chinese, Japanese, Indian, and almost all European firms and others from the US and Americas see Nigeria as a viable market. These companies either set up production assembling plants in Nigeria or export tons of container to Nigeria. Firms even in Asia and fellow African countries do not believe they have succeeded in their internationalization policies if their presence is not yet felt in Nigeria. Now, if every Nigerian is a scammer, why do these companies sell their goods and services to? From whom do they buy raw materials and spare parts? Whose services do they engage, and whose merchandise do they buy to live and work in Nigeria? You guess they did not bring all those things and those people along with their respective countries. One more fact that is usually downplayed is the uncommon acts of transparency and impressive honesty being displayed by many Nigerians. A recent example of this is that of a bank security man, Nkem Odo, who returned a sum of 10 million Nigerian naira that a bank customer who mistakenly left in the locker. We have read about other bank customers who reported money mistakenly credited to their accounts. Things like this happen frequently in the country. A popular story was that of Abayadun, a senior waiter in a big Nigerian hotel, who found a bag of cash containing the equivalent of $1,827 USD while locking up the hotel banquet hall one evening. He did not hesitate to turn in the money, which was later claimed by the owner. Nigerian airport cab operators have provided unsolicited help to foreigners traveling with huge cash. School children have turned in wallets and other money lost and found. These are just a few examples of how Nigerians have shown themselves to be transparently honest. There are thousands of doctors, attorneys, teachers, accountants, and other professionals who are of Nigerian descent in all corners of the earth. Most of these live above board. It is obvious then that not all Nigerians are scammers. In fact, Nigeria has the strongest criminal code prescribing all forms of scam and 419. The expression 419 was derived from a military decree number 419 prescribing advanced fee fraud under the pain of death over 30 years ago. The Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, and the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offenses Commission, ICPC, have strong legal backing to prevent and treat charges of scam. Scammers worse than Nigerians. While Nigeria is a nation most often referred to in scams, there are scams from other nations. For instance, 2006 statistics traced 61% internet scammers to the US, 16% to the UK, and only 6% to Nigeria. Ivory Coast, Togo, and South Africa are other African nations with a high incidence of 419. European countries such as the Netherlands, Spain, and Poland have also bred scammers, and a lot of Jamaican, Mexicans, and other scammers have originated in America as a whole. So as far as the scam is concerned, while Nigeria is full of scams, the country is some little fish in a large ocean. There are big boys and real scam lords that Nigeria scammers are small in comparison to. These guys have made billions of dollars in their illegal business. They are into what the most notorious, successful Nigerian scammers are not yet dreaming of. These guys are teachers of Nigerian scammers and have worldwide syndicates. No security is too complex for them to compromise. Securities of countries' databases are not strong to them to break. All passwords are simple to them. They can hack any institution's entire security. Proportionately, Nigeria is nowhere close to being the scam capital of the world. Mexico, Romania, Vietnam, Malaysia, Colombia, and Brazil all have higher scam rates than Nigeria. Consider, if there are 25 scammers to 5 Romanian scammers, which country would you conclude have more scammers? On the surface, it is Nigeria. However, comparing 19 million population of Romania to 200 million in Nigeria, you will realize that Romania has, on average, more scammers than Nigeria. Even though the Nigerian figures are high, per capita crime rate according to several findings places Nigeria out of the first 10. Nigerians excel in their chosen profession worldwide and issue scams. Whenever Nigerians find themselves in a society where there are opportunities, they have been known as industrious and creative rather than resorting to scamming. Research shows that most of the recent bachelor's degree holders from American universities are Nigerians, while average Americans do not have the drive and inclination to further their studies. The culture of the majority of Nigerian tribes and ethnic groups are averse to scams. This is because their traditional religions frown at it and punish the offender with great severity. The Nigerian scammers are found among those who embrace foreign religions. It is the hypocrisy of these religions that ignites the passion for fraudulent practices encouraged by bad leadership and the economy. One fact is clear, it is hard to scam a Nigerian living in another country. They do not easily release sensitive personal data, so forget about identity theft. With this attitude, they have been the best financial security experts and best network administrators for companies where they are employed. They have successfully insulated their employers against such fraud. What can we conclude? From the facts above, it is obvious that there are many scammers in Nigeria, but not all Nigerians are scammers. There are war scammers in countries other than Nigeria. At the same time, there are upright Nigerians throughout the world carrying out their legit businesses. The population of Nigeria is huge, so the number of very good and bad in the country is expected to be. This is not an indication that they have the worst, and by the same token, the best of everything. If you love this video, share, watch more, and subscribe to our channel.